distinct honor and privilege to introduce the next mayor of Charleston, South Carolina. My dad, John Tecklenburg. Many of you might have known my uncle Bill Earhart, but he would have said, "Ain't it grand?"
Ain't it grand?
So thank you for being here. First, I want to take a second and thank a few folks. And the first thanks I have is to our God and Creator. I want to thank God. To God we give the glory. We give Him the glory. Next, I would like to thank the voters and the citizens of Charleston for this. You know, they have given to me a blessing, an incredible opportunity of service, and I so look forward to serving this city. And I say that to the voters who voted for me today and who voted for Representative Stavonakis, because I plan to roll up my sleeves and go to work for all the citizens of Charleston. So next, I got to thank my family, of course, and this wonderful woman here, Sandy Tecklenburg. She's incredible, and she will be a fierce advocate for helping our brothers and sisters in this community. You know that. And all my children are here, and nephews and nieces, but I know they won't take offense by my singling out my dear son Joseph, who managed this campaign. Next, I got to thank all the incredible volunteers who helped in this incredible effort. I was so up. So many people have helped with the campaign, but I got to tell you, it was so uplifting when I went by the phone bank this afternoon, and there were 50 folks in there just dialing away, and it just lifted my spirits. But there's one special volunteer that I got to particularly thank who's been so helpful in the last couple of weeks to help make it this possible, and that's Jenny Deering. Thank you. Y'all, I want to thank Representative Leon Stavonakis. He ran a confident and spirited campaign. He's been a real public servant for Charleston as county council chair and county councilman, and as a member of our House of Representatives. And he did call me this evening on my way over here very graciously congratulating me, and I have to tell you that we really look forward to working together, Leon and myself, to make Charleston a better place. And I thank Leon and his family, his wife Ann, and Claire, and his entire family. They've really done a lot for this community, and we should be thankful to them. So I'm proud that Charleston is the number one place in this country to visit. I'm really proud of that. I don't want to be number two. I don't want to be three. I don't want to be last. I like being number one in something. But I also want to be the number one place for us to live, for us folks to live here. And from that simple statement, falls all kinds of quality of life issues that impact this community and that we're going to work on in the future. It includes improving our basic city services, making sure that city government is being run efficiently and well. And it means doing so in an open fashion that's open to the public. We need to have an open book and a high standard of ethics in city government. We need to make it easier. Thank you. We need to make it easier to communicate with our city. I mean, there's simple things we can do by having a centralized 311 number that you call for basic city services to make it easier for our citizens. We need to have tourism management downtown. And you know, quality of life, thank you. Quality of life issues vary depending on where you are in this city. Downtown quality of life is, tourism management is really important. West Ashley, we need some strategic economic development. Yes. West Ashley too long has been the red-headed stepchild of our city. And I'm here to tell you that I love redheads. Yeah. On James Island, we need to declare a peace treaty with the town of James Island and the public service district. And we need to get along to provide quality service to our citizens, no matter where they live. We need to manage growth in the city of Charleston, folks. We have a lot of people moving here. We'll be 1 million people in another 20 years, and we have to manage that growth. We need to review our zoning and what's allowed to be built in this city. We need to build a senior citizen center, West Ashley, and get that done to serve our citizens. We need to build a community center on Daniel Island and deal with the growth that is upon the Kainhoi Peninsula. We need infrastructure improvements in roads and flooding and drainage in our city, everywhere. We need to promote the cultural arts and spread the wealth of arts throughout our community and in our schools. You know, this year was a defining moment for our city's history. And let me ask for your attention, please. This year was a defining moment in our city's history, with the terrible tragedy that we saw at Mother Emanuel Church on June 17th. And this city showed the world how to respond to a tragedy with love and compassion and forgiveness. I mean, we impressed the entire world. And I have to say, in solidarity, and I'm wearing my little American-French flag combo pin this evening, that we should have solidarity with the city of Paris in the wake of the tragedy that has occurred there. And it was so similar in a way to what we experience here, because it was an assault on humanity, an assault on civilization. So Miss Bonnet, my high school French teacher, would be proud, I think, for me to say, nous sommes tous Parisiens aujourd'hui. Today we are all Parisians. But the reason I bring this up, folks, is because having a defining moment like we've had and we've now seen in the world today, it's not just how we immediately responded with this love and compassion. And it wasn't even bringing down a flag from a flagpole that needed to come down for so long. It's about, what are we going to do next to build this community? What are we going to do next to build this community? And we've got some big things to work on. We've got some big things to work on in Charleston in this community. I'm not a career politician. I guess by today's election, I've become a political figure. But I don't have all the answers. I don't have all the answers, and we need to work together as a community, collaboratively, being inclusive to figure out our problems and move forward. It takes all of us together, not just one person as mayor. I'm going to paraphrase a statement that I know you're all familiar with that I don't even need to quote. And I'm going to challenge the citizens of the city of Charleston and our whole region going forward from this day and ask you to ask yourself not what Charleston can do for you, but what can you do for Charleston? What can you do for Charleston? Because we have those kinds of challenges to work on, from our infrastructure, our getting around, our transportation. Everybody knows we got to work on it. And there are many things to do, from building new roads to finally trying to put in place a decent public transit system that will work for our community, to trying to make it easier in certain parts of our city for folks who like to walk and ride their bike, that can be a suitable alternative to driving your car. Folks, we need to help our schools. We need to help our schools. Education is the great equalizer. It's the great equalizer. And we have achievement gaps. And so I'm challenging folks to be a mentor. Get involved in your school, and together we will create a collective force to bridge those achievement gaps in our schools. It's an imperative. It's an imperative. We have housing affordability challenges in Charleston. We make less on average than folks in other parts of the country, but yet our housing costs are 120 to 150% higher than other places in the country. It's supply and demand, and we have to increase the supply of affordable housing in this city. Yeah, my background is in business and economic development. I had served as your director of economic development for the city. And it's something as booming as it seems our economy is, there are folks that are looking for jobs. And we need to help connect those folks, even if it takes some training and some vocational skills, to fill jobs for our people in Charleston. Folks, we need to help our brothers and sisters in this world. We need to help our brothers and sisters. That's how we become. That's how we earn the name of being the holy city. That's how we earn the name of being the holy city, is by helping our brothers and sisters. You know, I served with the crisis ministry years ago, but now we have tent cities of homeless people living under our bridges, and we need to help folks in our community. So I know I've carried on too long, so I'm starting already to take after Mayor Joe just a little bit. So let me conclude by thanking you once again for this incredible opportunity and tell you that with this challenge to serve this community, I believe Charleston has a place in this world to show folks not just how to come together after a tragedy, but how we're going to work together, how we're going to solve challenges in our community together, how we're going to just get along together and make Charleston the number one place to live. God bless you all. Thank you very much.